So this is the kind of video I like to make where I talk about business ideas that I think anybody can start. And the reason why I make some of these videos, like I said in the previous video I did, if you don't know, I made a video some weeks ago where I talked about some businesses that anybody can start in this pandemic and make money. And these are business ideas that I asked my friends and also myself. I considered myself and I considered if I would pay for this kind of things. And so I've made more ideas, I've jotted down more ideas, which I'm going to give you in this video. And it's really been helping a lot of people. You know, people have been reaching out to me saying that the videos, they're finding it very helpful. They're getting different ideas on how to start businesses. And the reason I'm doing this is because I want people to understand that whenever you hear about online business, about making money online, I want you to understand that it's not just about selling a course, because that's what most people think when it comes to making money online. Like, it has to be about selling a course or about doing affiliate marketing or about doing dropshipping or e-commerce or one of those other things. I want you to understand that online business is not about that. Online business is simply a business that happens online. And business for me can be defined as simply finding a problem and selling a solution to it. So it doesn't mean that you have to create a course, even though some courses solve problems and there are solutions to problems. It doesn't mean that you have to be into e-commerce. It doesn't mean you have to do affiliate marketing. You can actually do these businesses. And one thing you're going to discover is that all these businesses, they all rely on the same principles, right? The foundation is similar, right? It's all about problem solutions, problem selling solutions. So that is the foundation of all of them. But I just want you to understand that you don't really have to start making your own courses and selling, even though that is good, but there are many other businesses that you can start and make money. So without further ado, I'm going to jump into the ideas I have in this video. I'm going to try and explain as much as possible when I talk about each one. And then if I find resources for each and every business idea I talk about, I can list it. You know, I didn't see these ideas anywhere. It's simply me sitting down, thinking about the kind of things I would pay for and things that my friends are willing to pay for. So without further ado, let's get into the video. The first business idea is DM repliers. Now, I think I made a post about this on my Instagram where I'm going to put it up here on the screen so you can see what I said in that post. But essentially, a problem I noticed with most business owners, because I get a lot of them in my inbox and then I see their ads, I even see their content, I realized that most of them really don't know how to handle their DMs, right? Most people don't know how to handle their DMs. You go into the comment section of their pages or their profiles, their professional handles, and you're seeing comments that haven't been replied for weeks, for months, nobody's attending to it. You send them a message in their DM and it takes hours to get a response. This is a very, very big problem, and you know, it really impacts how people look at your business, because most people are online and they are expecting that whenever they send you a message that you reply immediately, you reply very quickly. And if you don't do that and people notice that that's how your business operates, they're going to look for another person. So DM repliers is a business idea that many people actually need. People actually need this and people are willing to pay for it. So if you're a professional, if you're very good in customer care, you can relate to people very well, this is a business idea that would be very, very good for you. And you can make a very good income doing this if you get one client and then you prove that you can actually do what you say you can do. You know, you're not just going to be spending time on your phone every single day, not doing anything, not making money. You're just spending money on data. If you know how to do this, you can actually start a business from that. And as time goes on, you can always scale it up by getting more people, you know, and just branching out into other services. The key thing I'm going to say here is that if you are trying to do this business, for me personally, what I feel is that if you're going to do this, you should actually stick to one service. I see many people trying to do a service like this, and then before you know it, they started adding other things that you can do. Here's the thing, and you know, this goes both ways. If you start adding other things, the money they're going to pay you will start to look little, especially when you're not outsourcing it. And even if you're outsourcing it, I mean, how much do you want to pay somebody to do this kind of work? Because this is actually good work. What you should do instead of putting your prices down is to actually offer your value, position yourself as a value provider. Remember what I said at the beginning of this video? This is all about giving a solution to a problem. So if you position this particular service as something that brings value to a business, imagine a business that would lose over 100K in their DMs. right? They lose over 100k in their DMs every single day, and you're coming in and you're helping them save that money. I don't know what kind of business owner would not be willing to pay a good amount for just that service. So you want to pitch it like that. Don't go and pitch everything, and then at the end of the day, when they pay you a little money, you start complaining that you are doing a lot of work for little money. So I want you to focus on this idea. Make it like a niche kind of thing, that this is what you actually do and this is what people know you for. And it's going to be very easy for you to enjoy the work that you're doing, or at least you feel happy, you feel satisfied, and you actually put your best foot forward and carry out this business. So that's one thing I'm going to say that you should watch out for. Don't start adding everything or start making the service too expensive because you want to add everything. I don't feel it's going to work, and you know, this is just my idea, it's my opinion, but feel free to do with it what you will. The second one is software reviewers. Now, if I know anything about online business, and if I'm correct, after courses, right, the next thing that people have no objection buying, or that it's very easy to demonstrate the use of, is software, right? Whether it's apps on their phone or whether it's software on their system, software is something that people buy a lot, because software is something that you can show immediately the problem that software solves, and then people can buy into it. So you can start this as a hustle. There are sites like AppSumo that gives deals on software. You can sign up on AppSumo, get different products, review it, and tell people about it, and then you become known as a software review person. You simply review software and people get to buy the software because of you. Now, the way you make money with this is through affiliate marketing, because if you sign up to a site like AppSumo, you can sign up to the affiliate program, which I'm signed up on, and literally every month right now I'm receiving commissions from AppSumo for just recommending products that I actually use. And I'm not even saying you have to use this software, because with AppSumo, you know, they have a very strong money-back guarantee. So what you can do, this is just my advice anyway, but you can get the software, you know, review it, just screen record, talk about the software, and then you can always pay, you can always get your money back. Like, you can just return the software and, you know, get another software and do the same thing like that. And you can even start up a business just from that, or you can choose to stick to just a part, some few software, and be the person that reviews it, or you sign up to the affiliate program by visiting the website. I've talked about this in previous videos on my channel, which you can check out. So that's another way to make money. And remember, because it's software, most of them you're getting paid in USD, so you're going to be getting paid in dollar, and then whenever you convert that money, you're going to see that it's actually a good monthly income. So do check out software reviewing. It's a very cool business. I've seen some few people making a killing with it, and you know, it's just a business idea that you can consider to make money for yourself. The next one is traffic senders. Now, do you guys, if you ever taken public transport in Lagos, you know those guys at the park, those touts, you know, some of them are touts, but some of them are conductors, and you know, essentially their job is to help other buses to load. Like, you know, they're just there shouting, "Ojo Leba, my two, what's the other one that they normally call, my two CMS, you know, Oshodi," all those kind of things that they call. And they're busy helping the bus drivers to get more people into their buses, right? So I'm going to relay that. I'm just using that as an example to talk about this next point, which is traffic senders. So there are people who hold classes online. There are people who hold different courses, you know, classes and all that. They hold it in groups like Telegram or WhatsApp. And you can be the person that helps them fill up those groups every time that they need to do a training. So you can meet someone who you know is regular with creating WhatsApp classes, and then you can link up with them and help them drive traffic for a particular one-time fee. Now, the money is not going to be a lot, but what happens is you begin to achieve skill. If you're known as the person that drives people to valuable conversations online, people are going to start watching out for your page. People will then end up following you, and then you're just simply driving traffic anytime that someone has a program to sell. Now, this is also good for you, because one thing I've noticed is that whenever you're putting yourself as the person who is selling something every single time, people are going to run away from you. But if you're positioning yourself as just this value provider and you're just the person helping people to go where they want, like there's no financial obligation on your part, people are going to be more receptive to whatever you have to say. So traffic sending is one of those ways that you can use to make money online. It's a very good business idea, and I think that if you really want to do this, just do more research, find more people, more influencers who are doing this kind of programs on offers, and you know, reach out to them and draw up an agreement with them, or reach just an agreement with them, and then you're on your way to make some good money. The next one I have here is copy reviewers. Now, for this one, you're going to need to have a skill, unfortunately, but this is a skill that's going to help you a lot, and that is a skill of copywriting. So if you really don't know how to start copywriting right now, if you don't know about copywriting, I'll leave a link, a resource in the description that you can use to get started. But then essentially, copy reviewers is the work you're basically doing is helping people to look at your copy and help them to, you know, remove some things or add some things, or basically just helping them to write their copy and make it better. There are a lot of businesses that do not know how to write copy that converts. They do not know how to write words that sell. And so if you can help them to do it, or whenever they write, you help them look at their content and, you know, just work up some things, you're going to be able to make money for yourself. And then at the end of the day, you know, you already have a valuable skill. So if you decide that this is not what you want to do with the talent, you can just start your own business, or just offer this as a full-blown premium service for people who can actually pay for it. So copy reviewing is a big business idea that, you know, it can also be used for small businesses or big businesses, whichever you decide to do. But it's also an idea that I think anybody looking to make some extra money can look into. And then last but not the least are podcast creators. And podcast creators, the idea I'm talking about here essentially is for people who want to create content on social media, specifically on social media. So there's this apps, there's new different type of apps that do this, but there's this app that you can put your voice on it, you can put an image, and then you have some like audio transitions showing on the screen and stuff like that. So most of the apps that actually do this are paid. The ones that do it very well are paid, and most people don't want to pay for that, but they see that graphic, they see that illustration, and they really like it. They want to be able to put out content like that on their social media. You can be the one to help them do this. This is going to require some financial investment on your part, because if you're using an app like I think it's Headliner or Wave Video or Pod Video, I'm going to leave the links in the description. But when you use these apps, in order to use it for a longer period of time, like to have content that goes out at a longer duration, you have to actually pay for the app. So you can pay for this app, you can create content with it, send out to people's DMs and tell them if they like it, that you can create this for them at a one-time fee. And remember, you're not really doing much work here, because all you're doing is just, you know, they just send you their content, probably they send you their voice, which they record with their phone recorder. They send you the content, you simply whip up the graphic, and then you put it into the software, and then it creates that whole beautiful effect. You know, I'll actually put a sample of what I'm talking about on the screen so you can see what I'm talking about. So to create something like that, I'm very sure people will pay for it, because I've put out content like that. People are always reaching out to me saying, you know, how do you do this? How do you do that? And then when I send them the name and then they discover that it's paid, most people just back off, because maybe they don't want to put their card online, or they find paying online stressful. But I'm very sure if there's someone that offered this as a service, those people would not mind doing this. So in order to win with this particular method, what you can do is offer it as a bundle. So you can say, I'm not just going to do the software thing for you, I'm going to do your graphics. Probably I'll do like 30 in a month for you, so that you can see how it is and see how it helps your channel grow. You know, you can also do it on IGTV, for example, on Instagram. You can use it on Twitter. You can use it on Facebook. You can use it on pretty much any social media, even on YouTube. So that is how to pitch that service to people that are interested in it. And remember, all these businesses is just about getting scale. So the more people that you have that you're working for, the more money that you are able to make. Whew, that was a mouthful. But those are the ideas I have currently. And guys, as I get more ideas like this, as I'm thinking of more ideas, I'm going to be making videos on them. So tell me, which of these ideas did you vibe with the most? Which ones are you going to start? Which one are you going to introduce to your brothers and sisters and get them to start? And which ones do you think have the capacity to make over 7 or 8 figures, depending on how you run it? Let me know your thoughts. If there's anyone you missed out, or if there's one you want me to research, or talk about, just let me know everything in the description. If you want to thank me, just make sure you subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. Make sure to share this video also with your friends and family. Make sure to like the video and don't forget to turn on the notification bell so you get notified once I put out a new video on the channel. Till I come your way next time, take care, peace.